Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, and in this video we are gonna talk about very important thing. But before that, finally I had a haircut because my mom convinced me with her some fictitious or vague point that why having short haircut it's super good. And till then I realized this point are super useless or baseless. I already had a haircut, but in this video we are not gonna talk about that. It again ruined my that thing of having a long hair, but no issue, we'll do it again. And in this video we are gonna talk about a very important thing, that some points that you should definitely try out in college. This point I have curated seeing that if I am joining to the college again, or if I get a chance to join the college again, what I can do from the first year. And I wish that somebody have told me this point when I joined to the first year of college. So we are gonna talk about that points out here. So till then, you can hit that subscribe button, do leave a thumbs up, and let's get started. First and foremost, competitive coding or DSA. So these two are two different things but closely related. Competitive coding. Competitive coding is actually practicing some problem based on data structure and algorithms on various platforms like LeetCode, CodeChef, CodeForces, and there are hundreds of platforms like that. So what happens is people go on their site and they have various problems listed on their website, and what people do is they start solving the problems and they build some logical skills out there. So competitive programming is super important for building logical skills. So various people you'll be hearing that they do competitive programming and they have various stars on this platform. So these stars they got by playing contest. So this particular website like CodeChef or CodeForces host various contests where people come and participate and get a rank. So they have various people and they give a rank to that people. So there are various type of concept contest, like short contest that happens to 2.5 hours to 3 hours, or long contest that expand to 10 days as well. So this things is super important to do, because doing competitive programming gives you a basic logical idea. You can use that in your interviews. So interviews generally have a problem round or coding round which you crack and go to the further rounds. So for that round it prepares you very well. And also there are various contests going on like Google Code Jam, ACM ICPC. So you can definitely participate in that, and there are huge benefit in participating that, and also you can go to various rounds as well. So consider ACM ICPC for doing it once also. Even if you make it to the regionals, it's a super good thing. Okay, so competitive programming and DSA is one of the thing. The next thing is development. So various people we have heard of that development and competitive programming are two different things, but one can definitely should try both in their college life. There could be some ratio that okay, 60% I'll be doing this and 40% I'll be doing this, but you should definitely do that, because selecting a development framework where you are interested in, you are really interested in, and selecting that and building project is super important, because at the end, cracking the coding interviews, at the end in the job you are going to do development only. You are not, so end of story is doing development only. So make sure that you do development and have some hands-on, because what happens is when you develop something, you do have some projects to show to the recruiter or interviewer. So you have some project, you can also put them on resume or any sites, and you can share with the world as well. So one main thing of development, you get the results immediately, while in competitive programming you get stars. That also means a lot, but again you can see the things immediately in the development world. So you can definitely try out this development and have project in your resume. This can drive the conversation from various other abstract topic to the projects, and you have done your projects and nobody knows better than you for that project. So make sure that you do some project as well. Next thing, once you do development, there are various things like hackathons you could participate on. So once you participate on hackathons, they have some huge and good prizes to check out for. So hackathons are simply contest which ranges from 24 hours or 48 hours. There are various hackathons. So what you do, you go there and you build something. What you build projects with the help of development. So here comes the real development. Within that particular span, you are building something and the judging team will be judging you based on that particular developed product. So this is one of the best thing that one can seek for in development. Again, it also helps in the interview rounds as well. So do development, do computer programming, have a match between them. I will also bring some further videos that how you can synchronize both of them, right? Also, many of you ask that what should I learn, mobile development or Android development or web development or any sort of thing. Choose anyone, that doesn't matter, you are really passionate about. Suppose when you are choosing, choose a tech stack. So suppose you wanna build web, so choose stack like MERN or MEAN stack. So MERN stack is one of the leading stack in the current days. So MERN stack typically have Mongo in it, Express in it, React in it, and Node in it. It's totally build the full stack development. So once you learn MERN stack, it will be full stack. So you can build any kind of app. So similarly, you can select any type of tech stack and build upon the projects, right? So let's move on to next point. Next thing is do open source. So GitHub account is one of the most important thing to build up. So many of us do not have a GitHub account as well. So what do? You build a GitHub account and whatever development you've learned and you are building project, you are pushed to that GitHub account. So this is known as doing open source. So in that open source, what happens is your code is open, anyone can view it, modify it and use it in their way as well. So open source is the third thing you should definitely check out in college life. Again, it have also various things like Hacktoberfest to do. So Hacktoberfest generally comes in once in a year, so you can try out that doing open source. So open source have several benefit as well. You can also put them in the resume and you can also build some great open source project that are used by many people, so they have some good reviews for you. And you can also put that project in your resume and also mention that these are used by certain group of user or certain number of people. So make sure that you have that GitHub profile and you start uploading your open source project over there. So many people do also need that, they have some need to have some security to their code that nobody can see it, but they wanna share that project. What they do is they create a private repository in GitHub and host the project there and add Netlify or any other services to it and deploy the project over there. They have a URL but you can't see the code, but you can have that particular project. So this way they can share to the world the project, mentioning that in the resume, but they don't want to share the code. That is one thing you can do. But doing open source is a great thing and various people can also reach out with opportunities by seeing your GitHub code as well. This also happens. One thing is everybody when start uploading project to GitHub, but many people think that they have very simple project to upload to GitHub and they don't think that this is very simple project and uploading this is no meaning. But don't do this. Even if you have simple project, do upload it to GitHub and eventually you start reading others code and various things, and eventually you understand that I have this particular sense of code idea now and I can start building good things. This way you can start building good things as well. So doesn't matter how small is project, do upload it to GitHub and at some point and a further point you can eventually have that sense that now my code like this and my code like this, and you can read other codes as well. This is one of the greatest thing, and open source have great features of Hacktoberfest to utilize it. It comes every year, so now you have some essence of this open source. And the last and foremost thing, what I'm doing with my hands, I'll keep it here. So last and foremost thing is building a community. I can't control my hands, I don't know why. So building community is very important. So various, you have seen various people that, okay, they apply for various ambassador program or various things that are good thing to do as well, but remember that you are learning something. So you can, you might see that CodeChef ambassador or GeeksforGeeks ambassador, there are various posts like this. What you can do is build a community in your college. So what happens is generally a college have various clubs where people go and share and contribute and connect with others. Similarly for coding also, you can have a club, you can share various things, you can have various representatives as well for these things like ambassador, and you can call various speaker, good speaker from outside or anyone who sharing knowledge, willing to share knowledge to the students, and they can connect. So what happens is this way various students and various people in the college can interact with the outsider people or outsider students or outsider anyone who have some different level of thinking and share things as well, and they can grow. And one thing is do, if you get a chance to teach this event, in this events hosting some workshop or anything in this particular events in the college, make sure that you do it, because teaching is real learning. So you can teach there, you can also go to the workshop conducted by other people, you can learn there and things like that. So there are always some people who know better than you, this is what I feel. So you can always learn and learn from them, and they know how things work and you can learn from them always. So do this thing, build communities and interact with others. Okay, so these were some things that I wish I would have known in college when I was starting out. This is not an extensive list, but a good list to start with. So I'll keep on bringing this type of things on my channel. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. Do leave a thumbs up on this video and other videos as well. Do let me know in the comment section that what you want to see in the further upcoming videos, because I don't have idea what to do next. So I have many much idea, but I have to prepare for them as well. So do leave a comment out here what you want to see next. I will add it to my bucket list, and whenever I get time, I create a video. So till then, hit the subscribe button. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye. I don't know how people do that outro thing. I'm bad in it, but eventually I'll learn. Bye.